these five values among the memory drugs, and 109 is the variance for placebo drugs, 112.3 is no drugs, variance for no drugs at all. Okay, now we'll be needing these some of these values as well. So let's just first calculate that. G is defined as the grand total. Okay, so the grand total is simply the summation of all these values. So let's just calculate that. We type in equal to, we need to sum all of them, therefore we use the sum function, and inside the brackets, and complete the brackets and press enter, you get the G. Okay, now CF is defined as the correction factor. Correction factor is defined as G squared by N. Now capital N is the number of values, number of the values or the number of observations. Okay, so let's just first find the number of values. We type in equal to, we use the function count, and inside brackets select the data, complete the brackets and press enter, you get N as 15. So let's calculate the CF. We type in equal to, we select this here, we multiply this with itself and divide it by the value of capital N and press enter, you get the CF. Okay, so now we go ahead and find the small n. Small n is the number of values for every group, which is 5 here. Now because every group has 5 values, therefore small n is 5. Now we have understood this table. Now we proceed to the ANOVA table. This is called the ANOVA table. You can see there that this column shows the sources of variations. Now the sources of variation could be between the groups. Now that it means that memory drugs, the variation between the memory drugs group and the placebo group is listed under between groups. Okay, and within the group it means that the variation inside memory drug, inside placebo drug, inside the students who were administered no drug. Okay, so SS is the sum of squares. Now to calculate these sum of squares, we have this formula here to calculate the sum of squares due to variation between the groups. We have this formula here. We sum over the t square values divided by small n, and subtract the CF value from it. Now t is, as we defined here, is the summation of all the columns here. Now this value is calculated as we square 417, 250 and 83, and then add them up and divide by small n. So let's just find this value. We type in equal to, we need to square and then sum, therefore we have another formula, another function, sumsq. We select this and inside the brackets select this data, complete the brackets. Okay, now we need to divide this with the value of small n, which is 5. Now from this we need to subtract the value of CF. CF is this here, and we press enter. That's it. You can see that these two values are the same. Now it is very difficult to calculate the sum of squares due to error or within the groups. So therefore we calculate the sum of squares due to the total variation, and then we will subtract these two values to obtain this value here. Okay, to calculate this we have this formula, sum of x squared minus CF. sum of x squared. X is simply the notation of all these values. Therefore, we sum all these values: 70 plus 70 squared plus 37 squared plus 3 squared plus 77 squared again, and so on. Okay. So let's find that. We type in equal to. We use the function sum sq. Inside the brackets, select this data, complete the brackets, and we subtract CF from it and press enter. See, you get the same value again. So it is verified. Now within the groups is now the sum of squares due to within the groups is calculated as the difference between the two. Therefore, we select this minus this and press enter. Again, the value is the same. Now there are degrees of freedom as well. Now degrees of freedom can be calculated by a simple formula. We will need the value of capital N and the value of small k. Okay, now small k is the number of groups that we have. Here we have three groups: memory drug, placebo, and no drugs. Okay, so therefore it is three. Now the degrees of freedom due to the variation between the groups is three. Therefore, the degrees of freedom, the formula for degrees of freedom is k minus one. We need to remember this formula. It is k minus one. Therefore, 3 minus 1 is 2. Therefore, the degrees of freedom is 2 here. Again, we calculate the total degrees of freedom. That can be calculated by a simple formula: capital N minus small k minus 1. Now we know, okay, the degrees of freedom for within the groups is N minus k minus 1. The total degrees of freedom can be calculated by capital N minus 1. Capital N minus 1. Now capital N is 15. 15 minus 1 is 14. Therefore, the degrees of freedom here is 14. Now this 12 is calculated by subtracting 14 and this 2 again. Okay. Now MS is the mean sum of squares. Mean sum of squares is this divided by this, you get this here. Now, so in a sense, we are calculating the mean of 11,155.6. Okay. Again, this 111.2 is calculated by dividing this and this. Now, F can be calculated as this divided by this. To verify that, let's say put equal to sign, select this, divide sign, and press enter. See, again the values are the same. Now we have the p value as well, and now we have the f critical value. Now this f value can be said to be f calculated value, because we have this value calculated. Now this f critical is known as f tabulated value, f tab, because we obtain this value from the table. So we have this table here. You can download it from the internet. And now we have the degrees of freedom listed. As you can see, this is the value of DF2. This DF2 is 12 for us. This is the DF2, and this is DF1. Okay, so we need to look at that value which corresponds to 12, 2. Now 12 is here, we have 2 here, and we need to look at the alpha value 0.05. these are the alpha values, standard alpha values for us. You have this table already calculated for some standard values of alpha. We look into the value corresponding to 0.05, we have this value here, 3.89. 3.89. Okay, which corresponds to 12 and 2. So let's look into our data. See, we have 3.885, which is fairly close to 3.89. So we have the F tabulated, we have the F calculated, we have the P value as well. Now we need to decide using these three values that we accept or reject the null hypothesis. Okay. So the condition for accepting the null hypothesis is that the F calculated should be less than the F tabulated. Okay. So obviously here the F calculated is 15, F tabulated is just 3. F calculated is greater than F tabulated. Therefore, we reject the null hypothesis. Or another condition that you could use is that this p value here should be less than the value of alpha. Alpha value is 0.05 for us, and this value is very, very less than the alpha. Okay, so to accept the null hypothesis, this p value should be greater than alpha. Which is not the case in here, because p value is very much less than 0.05. Therefore, we reject the null hypothesis. Now, what does rejecting null hypothesis means? That the treatments are not equal. We fail to accept the null hypothesis, which means automatically that we accept the alternate hypothesis. The alternate hypothesis is that all the treatments are equal to us. Okay. Now, what does accepting the alternate hypothesis mean for us? Now, if we are accepting the alternate hypothesis, it means that all of the treatments are not equal, of course. So, if you just look at the data, intuitively you can understand that there is a large difference between all of the three groups. Therefore, we conclude that the means are not equal. Means are not equal, or they differ significantly from each other. There is a very significant difference between the three values from all of the three groups. Here we have 3, here we have 90, we have 57. We can simply see that the students who were not administered any drug score very less than the other students who were administered placebo or memory drug. Okay, so it proves the effectiveness of the drug. So that's it for this video. Thank you.